everyone. Today I'm going to teach everyone alive about the miracle of the Northern Lights, also known as the Aurora Borealis. Isn't that interesting?
Actually, you're starting to Borealis already.
A small joke from a small man. Amusingly, ancient peoples came up with all kinds of ridiculous explanations for the lights, thinking them animal spirits or an omen of the war. Of course, now we all know the real cause.
Oh, electrons from the solar winds interacting with the Earth's magnetic field?
Very naive, Harold. No, the lights are actually the spirit of Aurora, Greek goddess of the dawn reaching across the heavens to communicate with her one true love, me. Look, there she is now, to the horizon line. Oh, false alarm, it's just an out-of-control bonfire. Come on, let's go.
Oh, maybe you should put it out, Gord.
Do I tell you how to do your job, Harold?
Well, you're in luck. Plane's taking care of it.
Yes, but with these low-lying storm clouds, we'll never see Aurora. Here, you two climb this surprisingly tall tree and take a picture of her to show everyone.
Oh, well, she's your true love, Gord. Why don't you do it, huh?
Clearly, you know nothing about women, Harold. I'm playing hard to get. Come on, now do it. Well, that was fast. Let's see the photo.
Oh, I think my fillings have melted. Oh.
Hang on, storm's clearing.
Oh, forget it, Gord. We can't see the lights, and even if we could, it's just a bunch of charged particles in the atmosphere. It's not a goddess.
Oh, really, Red? And what do you call that?
Gordon, I've missed you.
Well, I missed you too, Aurora.
Why haven't you called?
Well, gee, baby, you know, this is my busy time of year.
Oh, I can't believe we ever doubted him.
Well, truly, we are the fools.
That's right. Thanks for showing up, Dollface. You really know how to light up a room, huh?